imagine if you have a set of thousands of video files, audio files, images or documents. You need to perform some cognitive task on them like transcription or translation. So the solution is crowdsourcing. People here will be knowing what crowdsourcing is. So our software requirements were to import tasks into the files on which we want to perform the cognitive task, distribute the task among qualified users. We will be coming on to that later. Allow users to provide appropriate tags or transcriptions, that is to perform the operations. And evaluate the user provided type. Technologies we used are PyBOSA, a Python based crowdsourcing framework, Flask, a Python based web framework, PostgreSQL as a database, SQL Alchemy as an object relational mapper, and PGAdmin3 as a database administration tool.
We have used PyBOSA. It's a framework which actually supports crowdsourcing. All the built-in functionalities, basic functionalities required for crowdsourcing are already there. Problem is that it doesn't support local file importing. It only supports via some Google Drive or Dropbox or anything like that. And it also requires a Python script to be run, then convert the things into CSV using the Python script, and then it gets converted to JSON. It doesn't support importing from the local machine.
Show me the demo.
Yes, okay. Yes, so
we have no time.
Yes, sir. So this is our homepage. So it has a recommended project which the site admin can choose. So suppose Saket wants to contribute to a project. So he just selects a project. He knows a lot about Mohenjo-daro civilization. He wants to contribute.
So he basically contributes.
So first we have to answer a quiz to so that the project owner knows that he is eligible to answer.
He is eligible.
Yes, sir.
Next.
So he selects a quiz.
Eligible.
So he answers a quiz.
Eligible, yeah.
Sir, yes, he needs to answer it.
Login as some eligible user and show. So I can't do the full testing here.
Yes,
you must be having some eligible user, no, in your system. Or you're not tested at all.
Yes, sir. So this is the contribution.
So this is the
quiz has been given now. And
now
this
the
is
contribution begins. So what is this image? So suppose it's an animal. It has been tagged. He moves on to the next task. Now what is this? So this is a text document.
So you can write anything. Actually, they are simply tags.
Tell me how many iterations you are going to do with the one image.
No, there is a task redundancy parameter which is present in PyBOSA. So you can set it. Suppose you set it to 30, then the same image will be given to 30 users and 30 tags for the user will be.
So show me an image which has been given to 30 users.
Just tell me how many iterations you are going to do with the one image.
There is a task redundancy parameter which is present in PyBOSA. So you can set it. Suppose you set it to 30, then the same image will be given to 30 users and 30 tags for the user will be.
So you are not able to show me any tested end-to-end result. You have done a system, right?
Yes, sir.
So
sir, these things are already present in PyBOSA. So that's not what we have actually done.
So what have you done? Show me.
So we have done the local importer and we have added the quiz inside the system. So because the current system was not considering the user, because he was giving the tasks to the users in any fashion, he was not considering how the user is good, whether it is good or not. So that is why
I don't agree that it is to be done by a quiz. Why it should be done by a quiz?
No, sir, quiz is just for a starting evaluation.
Why?
Just to evaluate him.
Why?
So that we can.
Sorry, I'm very upset. Who are you? I got people saying Drupal is horrible, and now I got people saying your PyBOSA is horrible. It's a working system for a long time. It's collaborative community. It is supposed to be working. Thousands of people are using it. Now, four upstarts here come and say, I will add a quiz without attempting the quiz. I will not let you contribute. I don't know whether that is an acceptable thing,
sir,
in a collaborative
an option
community.
If the project admin wants a quiz to be taken before the
then only, it is
then
not,
only
it's
he can
not
choose if he wants.
Yeah, correct. So all the people who are using PyBOSA, all the project admins who are using PyBOSA are stupid people. They don't want to do that quiz. You are the people who want a quiz to be added. How can you change a process which is accepted by collaborative community?
Sir,
okay, okay. You added a quiz, correct? So that
sir,
is only
PyBOSA
that is only the entry point. Okay.
Yes, sir.
What else have you added?
We have added the local
file
importer.
No, quiz you added. I have not seen what you added in the quiz.
No, sir. Quiz actually can be.
Quiz is what you added, no?
Yes.
Explain the quiz to me.
So it's basically a set of MCQ questions to which the project admin already knows the answer to.
Correct.
So if the user.
Set up a quiz for me.
Yes, sir.
Just show me the interface. Don't write a quiz name. Okay, okay. Quiz name I'll accept. Then what do I have?
So question text.
Question text. Option 1, option 2. How many I can give?
4 options.
Options? Nahi yaar. How many questions I can give or
no,
one
multiple.
Question?
You
multiple.
You can give any number.
As much as you want.
As much as I want.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. What is the criteria? What is this image about? Where is the image?
Sir, I am uploading the image.
Oh, I have to upload an image. Okay. Okay, all right. So I have to upload an image, that's fine.
Yes, sir.
I upload an image, I ask some question about the image.
Yes, sir.
I give four options,
yes,
and I choose.
Yes,
so
sir.
That quiz setting you are implemented.
Yes, sir. Yes. We have implemented.
Okay. How do I specify rules? For acceptance and rejection.
No, sir. The correct answer can be said.
Correct answer I know. I have given 100 questions. That is what I am a stupid admin. No, I want to select. So if I want to give a selection, I will give 100 images, 100 answers, pura tum 10 घंटा काम करो फिर बाद में मैं सोचूंगा तुमको अलाउ करने का है कि नहीं दैट इज योर मॉडल बट ठीक है आई एक्सेप्ट दैट मॉडल वेयर डू आई स्पेसिफाई पासिंग मार्क्स
देयर आर नो पासिंग मार्क्स
इट्स नॉट
देन व्हाट इज द पॉइंट इन गिविंग 10 क्वेश्चंस ऑल 10 आर करेक्ट आई विल टेक एंड वन रॉन्ग आई विल नॉट टेक व्हाट इज द रूल्स
नो सर द वन हु इज बेटर एट tagging a particular image or a document or a video, we are actually categorizing it accordingly and then we will just give the tasks.
Show me how you are categorizing because I don't see any category here, whether it's image or a video, I don't see that.
Taken from the extension of the file uploaded.
Extension of the file.
Yeah.
So okay. I have written this quiz. Show me any quiz you have created. Okay. And the results of the people giving that quiz. Show me.
No, sir, the results are not actually shown to the user. Their results
admin
are just
ke,
used.
Admin log karke dikhao na. I want to look at test data, sir.
No, sir.
If you are not tested, then don't even talk to me about this.
No, sir, this
quiz. That software is useless. If you have written quiz, sir, I need to see the quiz result from an admin. Please show it to me.
Sir, the quiz results are not displayed to the user because
admin.
We are, no, not even the admin actually. Just because
you
we
said
just want to.
Who is going to make the call? He is good at video,
no,
he is
sir.
Good at tech, he is good at
no,
something
sir,
else.
No sir, it's not going to be done manually. It will be sorted basically. If he is good at images and audios, the best, he gets the highest score there, then he will be given images and audios.
How do you know by highest score?
By giving the quiz.
I want to see, you have put in a different process, okay? I am just evaluating whether your process is correct or not and after this you walk out. Okay,
yes,
tell me whether the process is correct or not. Because that is a major contribution, it seems you have done.
No, one more thing we have.
There
are many other things we have done.
First, this itself is wrong, then I will not go for further thing. No, I have no time. I am running 3 hours late.
No, sir, it's image, audio, video, and document is basically there. Then according to his answers, he will get a score for separately.
Correct. And that 10,000 people who have given scores. अभी क्या करना है उसका स्कोर का
नो
अकॉर्डिंग टू स्टोर्ड इट शो मी द डेटाबेस वेयर यू स्टोर्ड इट
नो सर अकॉर्डिंग टू हिज स्कोर्स देन ही विल बी गेटिंग सपोज ही गेट्स द मैक्सिमम स्कोर फॉर एन इमेज एंड एन ऑडियो सो ही विल बी
सो आई गेट 000 एंड 1 फॉर एवरी समवेयर 100 क्वेश्चंस आई आस्क तो 1 आई एम क्वालिफाइड आई व्हाट आर द रूल्स यार यू आर सेटिंग अप अ क्विज and you are not telling me what are the how answers you are using
so the tasks are distributed dynamically among users by algorithms known as schedulers So this
have you written the scheduler?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. There
you
is a scheduler.
Yes,
there
sir.
Is a scheduler. What it does is based on the maximum score which you get, according
sir,
to that.
Do one thing that show us a workflow diagram. That
yes.
is the best
yes,
way.
Yes,
in spite
sir.
Of
so
talking randomly, just show the workflow diagram.
This is
yes.
This is what it is.
And now explain the thing.
There is a project admin who
okay.
creates a task, uses the task importer for creating it. Project is created, then tasks are added. Task is any document has been added. Then it goes to the server. This is the crowd.
These results go to the task scheduler and seeing the results, the task scheduler takes the tasks and gives them to
so
the
you
user.
You have modified the task scheduler.
So there
yes,
are
sir.
Different varieties of task scheduler.
So we have added one.
We can also
so
add our
modified,
own.
We have added
yes, sir.
One variety of tasks.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Which takes as input your quiz data.
Yes, sir. Correct, sir.
Yes, sir.
So tell me what it does.
Okay, so then the image, audio, video scores.
I will take a test case of one user and 100,000 users. And you tell me what your task scheduler does. It's an algorithm you have written, no?
Okay, so it gives it.
One user with 0 marks, what are you going to do?
So that also actually is going to get some tasks, but that will be done on a random basis. And then when he contributes to the task, according to that,
okay,
we can train it.
Two users, one user with 0 marks, one user with 1 mark. What is your task scheduler going to do?
So for the 1 mark one, wherever he gets 1 mark, that is in image.
One
if
mark everywhere, yaar. I am a very simple man.
Okay, so he
one
gets.
Mark everywhere, 0 marks everywhere. Two okay. user hai. Kya karega tumhara task scheduler?
Okay, so then it will distribute it
every
according to
one,
the default one only. No sir, if everything is same.
I don't think you at all. I don't think you have done it properly. It is not properly tested. Okay, 100% not properly tested. You not just thought about it. You are just writing software. Same problem with a lot of other people also. It not tested. I know it is not tested. Otherwise you showed me.
Do you have a sample case available where you can demonstrate that this has happened, this has happened, this is output result? Do you have any sample
that case? We have not done. No. The testing we have not done with many users.
I'm very disappointed. Okay.
Quickly present the things, what else you have done. Just continue.
Existing Pibosa has two importers like Google spreadsheet and CSV. We have developed one importer that is a local importer that will be accepting zip format or tar.gz, and it will take the file and that will be categorized into four types like images, documents and videos and audios, and user can choose the files which they want to upload and he can add the questions for a particular category here.
See, this thing they have explained, you explain the other features. Continue.
And there is a editing question module also we have, and we have added task presenter. Existing Pibosa has a default task presenter, but that is
the Pibosa existing software has only task presenters relevant to an image or relevant to a video. It can't handle all of these based on what the input data is coming. So we wrote a task presenter which sees the input data is a video, image, a document, and
how you choose this? How you choose this, by extension of the file?
Yes, sir. By extension.
Is it a correct way?
So actually,
if I have got a PDF file, rename it as a JPJ, and then what it will do?
So, but if that happens in all the operating systems also, if we rename the file as .jpg, even the operating system becomes confused as to it is a JPG or a PDF. It shows that
there
it's
is
a
lot
file.
Of space for the hackers like me who can confuse your software very well.
And the one advantage is that using RESTful APIs, any other project who wants to crowdsource their data to us can integrate with us. We expect and give results in JSON.
Okay, thanks.
Yes,
next group.
Thank you.
Thank you.